And it's about time, Google. Google's Family Link app lets you hand down your old Android gadgets to your kids without worrying about what they could end up downloading from the Play Store, or even worse, finding online. You just have to create a Google account for your kids and then download the app. Family Link allows parents to approve or block apps that their kids want to download from the Play Store, monitor their screen time and the apps that they're using. You can even set device time limits and remotely lock your kid's device for bedtime or studying. This is a dream app for parents that is long overdue. Google is directly targeting Amazon and its kid-friendly Fire tablets with Family Link. Amazon's tablets always let parents set screen time limits, and it recently began letting parents retrieve more granular data on the apps that their kids are using and even the books and websites that they're accessing. It also launched a new parent-oriented dashboard back in April. Now, Google doesn't seem to readily give parents that kind of access through Family Link, and it says some messaging apps and music players won't even be tracked completely. Still, parents likely have old Android phones sitting around. I know I have a bunch, and of course, some old tablets as well that I would love to pass down to my kid if I could only secure them. As opposed to having to buy a whole new kid-oriented tablet, those things are pricey. Google is now giving you that option without the risk of your kids running rampant on the internet without any supervision. The app is available for kids so long as they're using an Android device that runs Nougat or higher. You can run Family Link on an Android device running KitKat or higher, or even on an iPhone running iOS 9. Or higher. I definitely suggest you check it out if you're thinking about handing down that old Android phone or tablet to the young ones. AMC Entertainment, the largest theater owner in the world, and Dreamscape Immersive, a location-based VR startup backed by some of Hollywood's biggest players, have announced a partnership. A wide-ranging strategic partnership that will rapidly scale the development and expansion of the Dreamscape system. Dreamscape Immersive ushers in an exciting new world in virtual reality and reminds us through its trailblazing, all-enveloping technology that we really are living in the 21st century. As part of the three-pronged partnership, AMC will lead the investor group in a $20 million Series B financing round. AMC will commit $10 million in equity investment into Dreamscape Immersive and will finance up to 6 Dreamscape Immersive VR centers within AMC Cinemas and even some standalone locations in North America and the UK over the next 18 months. AMC will also invest $10 million into a content fund. The company utilizes unique body mapping technologies, which gives participants full body presence as rendered avatars inside of extraordinary virtual worlds. Unlike other VR platforms, Dreamscape Immersive offers a social experience in which participants explore and interact with up to 6 people simultaneously, untethered from a computer, with full use of your senses, just as you would in the real world. Dreamscape Immersive has greenlit its first piece of original content and is currently in licensing conversations with several other major studios and IP holders. The company completed its Series A funding back in January with a roster of initial investors including Warner Brothers, 21st Century Fox, MGM, IMAX, and even Steven Spielberg. And finally, happening in this week's What the, Detroit police have arrested 45-year-old Janice Smith for supposedly catching various squirrels from her neighborhood and then training them to assault her previous sweetheart. 51-year-old James Robinson was assaulted by the rodents more than 12 times in the course of 1 month. These assaults caused him numerous injuries, including the loss of 2 fingers and one thing else gnawed off by his assailants. Ouch. The poor man had no clue why squirrels continued attacking him until he saw his ex, a previous carnival creature coach, cheering them on amid one of the assaults. Mr. Robinson said she had taken cover behind a few shrubs, yet I could unmistakably hear her shouting at the squirrels and instructing them to assault me. He then called the police, who visited Miss Smith and found 12 cages holding 27 squirrels. They additionally discovered two dummies with pictures of Mr. Robinson taped to the heads. Detroit Police Chief James Craig said Miss Smith admitted to catching and training the squirrels to assault her ex. She used to prepare lions for a carnival, so it was simple for her to influence the creatures to do as she needed. She said she would have liked to train up to 50 to 100 of the creatures. The 45-year-old is now being charged with criminal badgering and utilizing creatures as a weapon. Chief Craig conceded at a public interview that this case was most likely the weirdest that he'd found in his career. Smith's legal counselors have requested that she go through a mental assessment, asserting that she's unfit to stand trial. Now, on the off chance that doctors say she is fit to stand trial, Ms. Smith faces up to 65 years in jail. Thank you for watching your weekly tech update. If you have a story you think I should feature on the program, shoot me an email, djraymcneil@gmail.com. You can also find me on Facebook too, at your weekly tech update. Till next time, I'm Ray McNeil. Good night, world. Your weekly tech update brought to you by Holiday Home Care, Phillip Island, Victoria, Australia. It's your turn to relax.